على خط المواجهة.
Covering the confrontations between Al-Qaeda and Al-Jaish al-Islami or the Islamic Army, our cameras went into the battlefield in the area of Al-Amiriya, west of Baghdad. The images show the destruction of the city and the presence of members from the Islamic Army while people are trying to resume their normal lives after a period of relative calm. Majid Hamid reports.
ماجد حميد.
ليست مدينة أشباح وإن بدأت.
Although it looks like a ghost town, this area used to be well known in Baghdad as a place of flourishing commerce and as a thriving marketplace. Clashes between armed groups in Amiriya west of Baghdad have changed the face of this city. The Islamic Army, which is one of the factions of the Iraqi resistance, announced a war against Al-Qaeda in Iraq, or what has become known as the Islamic State. This fighting between people who were friends yesterday but are enemies today has been justified by leaders in the Islamic Army as a response to Al-Qaeda's killing and kidnapping of Islamic Army leaders in Baghdad.
The reason we are fighting Al-Qaeda is to end the oppression of our brothers and the tyranny of Al-Qaeda on this land.
الجيش الإسلامي نشر العشرات من المقاتلين في الجهة الشمالية.
The Islamic Army deployed dozens of fighters in the northern area of the city, which is under their control, and which has witnessed intermittent confrontations between the two rival parties using light weapons. The west of Al-Amiriya is still under the control of Al-Qaeda, but the eastern part is relatively calm, permitting the inhabitants to go out to buy food and fetch water, which had been cut off throughout the area. Destruction and ruin are readily visible in the city due to the various armed activities.
Only God can end it. Where are our sons? Tell me, where are they? Other than in prisons or beheaded and disposed of.
المواجهات الدائرة في العامرية التي تعد من
Al-Amiriya is considered to be one of Baghdad's hotspots since the occupation, with continuous clashes taking place in plain view of the American and Iraqi troops, which seem to have allowed the Islamic Army to operate and fight Al-Qaeda. This, despite the fact that the Islamic Army is one of Baghdad's most zealous armed groups in its targeting of U.S. troops who might be adhering to the proverb, the enemy of my enemy is my friend. Majid Hamid, Al-Arabiya, Baghdad.
بغداد.
ويبقى معنا ماجد حميد.
With us now is Majid Hamid in Baghdad. Majid, these images are being broadcast for the first time. But what is the background to the battle between the Islamic Army and Al-Qaeda? And does it extend to other cities and areas in Baghdad?
إلى مدن ومناطق أخرى في العراق.
نعم حول وتحديدا حول رسالة الدكتور النعيمي علي النعيمي المتحدث باسم
Yes, Dr. النعيمي, spokesman for the Islamic Army, said that the fighting between Al-Qaeda and the Islamic Army came after the Islamic State, which includes Al-Qaeda, killed and kidnapped a number of Islamic Army leaders in the area of At-Ta'miriya, Al-Amiriya, and other places in Anbar district. Several armed groups had previously engaged in dialogue with the Islamic State after fighting took place between the Islamic Army, the Thawrat al-Ishreen Brigades, and Al-Qaeda, but these negotiations failed. Al-Amiriya yesterday was indeed a ghost town, and we were only able to reach limited sections which are under the control of the Islamic Army, but we were unable to reach the other areas where the clashes were coming from, and which were under the control of the Islamic State, and where United States troops also led some battles. The speaker, Abu Zayed, who was interviewed in that area, said that the fighting will continue. He also made an important point, which is that the formation of a council to save Baghdad, supported by the tribes, is necessary.